Hey, what's going on everybody? It's your bro, hope you're doing well, and in this video I'm going to explain how dictionaries work in Python, so sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you wouldn't mind, please like, comment, and subscribe. One like equals one prayer for the YouTube algorithm. Alright, let's get down to business. A dictionary is a changeable, unordered collection of unique key value pairs. They're fast because they use hashing, and they allow us to access a value quickly. Now, to create a dictionary, it's very similar to creating a set based on the last video, except we're going to store unique key value pairs. Let's create a dictionary of countries and their capitals. We can store those as key value pairs. So let's call this dictionary capitals. Capitals equals, then we need a set of curly braces, much like what we use with sets. Now we need a key and a value. Let's say we have the USA as a key, and the capital of the USA would be Washington, D.C. So in order to associate a value with a key, we'll follow the key with a colon and then add some value. And the data type really doesn't matter, but in this case, we're just using strings. So the capital of the USA would be Washington, D.C. And to add another key value pair, we'll separate each with a comma. And let's add a few others for good measure. So let's say we have India next as a key, and the value would be New Delhi. And we'll add two more. Let's say we have China, and the capital of China is Beijing. And lastly, let's add Russia. And the capital of Russia is Moscow. And there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. We now have a dictionary called capitals that has unique key value pairs. So remember, with dictionaries, they are unordered. In order to access one of these values, instead of using a numbered index, we're going to use the associated key with that value. Here's an example. Let's say I would like to print the capital of Russia. So I need to use this key of Russia. So in order to do this, type in the name of the dictionary, followed by a set of straight brackets, and then instead of an index number like 0 or 1, 2, 3, I'm going to use the key. So I would like to print the value that's stored or associated with the key of Russia. So when I run this, this will print that value, which is Moscow. So this isn't always safe. Let's say we have a key that doesn't exist, like Germany. Germany is not currently within my dictionary. So if I were to run this, well then my program is going to encounter an error, and this will interrupt the normal flow of my program. A much safer way to access a key to check to see if it's there or not is to use the get method of dictionaries. So I'm going to turn this line into a comment, and let's try this again, but this time we'll use the get method. So type in the name of the dictionary, dot get, and list the key that you want to use. So I would like to see if Germany is within my dictionary. Currently there isn't, so this will return none, and we will not encounter an error, so this is a much safer way of checking to see if there is a key within your dictionary. Here's a few other useful methods. There is a method to print only the keys. So we type in the name of the dictionary, capitals, and here's a listing of all of the methods that we have access to. I'm looking for the keys method, and this will print only the keys and not the values. We can also print just the values and not the keys. So type in the name of the dictionary again, capitals dot values. And this will print only the values. Or you could print everything, both the keys and the values. And you do so by using the items method. Capitals dot items. And this will print your entire dictionary. One other way in which we can display all of the key value pairs in a dictionary is to use a for loop. So at the end, let's create a for loop. For key, comma value in capitals dot items. This is going to iterate once for each key value pair in my dictionary. For each key value in capitals dot items, print key, comma, value. And this will print my entire dictionary. A feature of dictionaries is that they are mutable. That means we can change them or alter them after the program is already running. So one way in which we can do that is to use the update method of dictionaries. So let's add Germany as a key and give it a value of Berlin. So type in the name of the dictionary, capitals, and we'll use the update method. And within the parentheses of this method, we'll add a set of curly braces. And now we can add a new key value pair. So let's add Germany and a value of Berlin. So if I were to run this and display all of the key value pairs found within my dictionary, we now have Germany as a key and Berlin as its value. Not only can you use the update method to add a new key value pair, but you can update an existing one. Let's say we would like to change the capital of the USA. So capitals.update, parentheses, curly braces, list the key, USA, colon, and then we can give the USA a new value. Let's pretend that the United States government has decided to relocate their capital to Las Vegas. So this will now update our key of USA with a new value. And if I were to print all of the key value pairs found within my dictionary of capitals, the USA has a new value of Las Vegas. So the last two methods I'm going to cover are both pop and clear. You can use the pop method to remove a key value pair. So capitals.pop, parentheses, and list the key of the key value pair that you would like to remove. So let's say we would like to remove China. So we'll list that key, and then when we use the pop method, that will remove this key value pair from my dictionary. And then of course we have clear as well, which will just remove everything. Capitals.clear. And this will clear my dictionary. Alright everybody, so in conclusion, a dictionary is a changeable, unordered collection of unique key value pairs. They're fast because they use hashing, and they allow us to access a value quickly. Well, that's the basics of dictionaries in Python. If you would like a copy of all this code, I will post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's how dictionaries work in Python. Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learned something new, then help me help you in three easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.